Lecture 14. Okay, so today we'll talk about power series. That is also kind of part of the infinite series. It's the next part of the infinite series. But yeah, that was a different chunk. We'll do some kind of, you know, we'll have few mathematical definition as far as power series is concerned. So let's see. Power series. Okay, so a straightforward definition is a power series. A power series about x is equal to a is a series of the form summation and runs from 0 to infinity, some kind of coefficients, and x raised to x minus a raised to power n. That means something like c naught plus c1 x minus a plus c2 x minus a whole square plus c3 x minus a whole cube plus and so on up to infinity. So if you take a special case that you want the power series at x is equal to 0, that means you replace this x is equal to a by x is equal to 0. So therefore, power series about x is equal to 0 is of the form, kuch nahi karna hai, kya karenge bas, a ki jagah pe 0 put kar denge. Sorry. So can you see this? Yes,
yes, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
A is equal to 0 liya ya x
equal to 0? X equal to 0 nahi hoga.
Nahi. A is equal to 0. A is equal to 0. About A is equal to 0. Right? Yes. So we actually take the power series about some value of x. Right? Then that value we generally call it as A. So in particular, we are taking A to be 0. Then A is called the center. Okay. We call this A as center of power series. And these are the coefficients, constants. Constant coefficients. We call them CIs. Okay. So you know that this thing is nothing but a power series, right? Is it a power series?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what about the center of this power series?
X bhi aayega na?
Zero.
Yes. X. Zero. And what are the CIs?
One.
सारे
एक्सक्यूज मी सर
यस
सर आपने एक टर्म मिस कर दी वहां पे एक्स भी आएगा
ओह सॉरी लेट मी पुट इट दिस वे राइट नाउ इट्स फाइन थैंक्स
यस
ओके सो नाउ यू नो दैट इट्स अ जीपी एंड इन अ पर्टिकुलर केस इफ योर मोड एक्स इज लेस देन 1 देन यू नो दैट this thing can be rewritten as 1 upon 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x square plus x cube plus up to infinity. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And what will happen if you take mod x is to be greater than 1 or equal to 1?
Some converge nahi karega.
Exactly. That's the point. See, it's an infinite series. If your mod x is greater than or equal to 1, how this can converge? This will not converge at all, right? You know that for GP to have this sum, the essential condition is mod x is less than 1. And other than these two cases, GP will diverge, right? So if you talk about this thing will become infinite. Okay, in this case, right? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So always keep in mind, see, your mod x minus 1 will, you know, with that, that can be applied only when you are dealing with the finitely many terms. Now, you have infinitely many terms. Of course, the sum will make sense only if your common ratio, the mod of the common ratio should be less than 1. Right? That's okay. So now, you see that, you noticed one point, that is, see, some powers of x are coming into the picture, but the sum may or may not be finite. It will be finite if your mod x is less than 1 and will be infinite if your mod x is greater than 1. So this series converge under special conditions, right? It may or may not converge every time, right? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So we'll be dealing with lots of such kind of series, but you see that now we'll go into another picture of this thing. So let's see. So now what I'm saying is I'll pick that whole thing over for the next page. Okay. And I'll make a rough picture. And this thing is already in the book as well. So I'm just explaining the things. Okay. So let's say I make it as, this is my x-axis and this is my y-axis. Okay. So if I pick only this thing, so what I'm doing is I'm only taking 1 over here. Okay. And I call it as P naught x. So I'm taking only first term. So let's say if I want to draw y naught is equal to 1, or let's say I draw a line y is equal to 1. So how we can draw the y is equal to 1?
Parallel to x-axis,
right? That would be a horizontal line. Okay. So let me draw this line. Let's say it is here. So this is your y is equal to 1. Okay. So now my next point is I'm taking it to be P1x, and in P1x, I'll take first 2 terms. That means 1 plus x. So if I take 2 terms, 1 plus x, so if I want to plot that 1 plus x, what kind of equation this will be?
Y
is equal to mx plus c, right? So if you see that, this is a line will pass through in this way, okay? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So
this would be, let's say, y is equal to 1 plus x. Now I add more terms. Okay. So let's say I take P2x. Okay. Let me put these 2 terms over here and I take P2x, and in P2x, I'll take first 3 terms. So that means 1 plus x plus x square. Now what is that?
It's a parabola. Parabola.
Parabola.
Yes, sir.
So that parabola will also pass through this point.
Yes, sir.
So that would look like, it will look like this way. Okay. So that is your, let's say, y is equal to 1 plus x plus x square. Okay. So now if I draw, let's say I want to draw this particular function, y is equal to 1 minus x. And what about y is equal to 1 minus x?
It's again a line which will be opposite to the origin, like jo aapne wo line banayi hai.
Any other point you want to make?
Perpendicular to y is equal to 1 plus x.
No. Okay. Rather than looking into this, you directly talk about this. What about this? Is it a line?
No, sir.
What is that?
Hyperbola.
What about this? Why it's not a hyperbola? It's a reciprocal function, right?
Yes, sir. It's
yes, sir.
So that will be a hyperbola rather than saying a line, because it's a reciprocal function. Okay. So when you plot that particular function, let's say I'll plot it. So it will look like something like this. Okay. So what do you see? So this is your, let's say, this is your y is equal to 1 upon 1 minus x. Now, what you're actually watching, so you can easily see that things are going in that direction. right? As we include more terms, let's say we take firstly we take only one term, then we take two terms, then we take three terms, and if we keep on adding these terms, the curve will go near to the actual sum, and this is your actual sum, right?
Yes, sir.
Is it fine?
Sir. Yes, sir.
So as you keep on increasing those terms, of course your sum will get close to the actual sum, right? Now, is this phenomena, you know, can be applied to anywhere in our real life scenario? Okay, I'll give you one exercise today that you're gonna check. Okay, so since you are CSE students, so I'll definitely give you an exercise which will be like along the lines of that computer stuff. Okay. So that's what we are actually mentioning over here, that as we keep on adding the terms, we'll go near to the 1 upon 1 minus x, and that is the actual sum of this. Okay, so is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Is it fine?
Yes,
so are you with
yes,
me on
sir.
This?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's talk about some few series. So now you see that in our previous series, the power series may or may not converge for every value of x. It may converge for few values of x, it may not converge for few values of x. Okay, so it depends. So let's say you need to find out those values of x for which that power series is actually converge, and that is what, let's say, okay, so if you talk about this one, let's say I start with this, let's say I consider the modulus of this one, that means I'm considering the absolute convergence. Okay, so now what's that? N runs from 1 to infinity, right? Mod xn upon n. Is it fine? Right?
Yes, sir.
It's fine?
Yes, sir.
So let's say you call it as an plus 1 upon an. Apply the ratio test over here. Okay. So that becomes what? Mod xn plus 1 upon n plus 1 into n by mod xn. Right? Is it right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
This will get cancelled. Sorry, this. And we are left with n upon n plus 1 upon mod x. Right? Now, what we're going to do? We take limit n tends to infinity on both sides. So this will be what? N upon n plus 1 into mod x. Sorry, I need to take the limit on both sides. So I'll also take the limit on this side as well. Okay. So now what is that limit? Can you tell me what is that limit?
Mod x.
So mod x.
Of course, mod x. You are left with mod x. Now, what do your ratio test tells?
The value of mod x is less than 1, then it converges.
So first case, you know that the given series will converge absolutely. Okay, what I'm talking about? Absolutely. Why? Because I've considered the mode. Why? Because otherwise I'll not be able to apply any test, right? Converge absolutely if mod x is less than 1 and diverge if mod x is greater than 1. And what about x is equal to, what about x mod x is equal to 1?
Inconclusive.
We know that
conditional convergence.
Yeah. So we know that our test is, the ratio test is inconclusive. Okay. So we cannot tell anything about when you are using the ratio test. You cannot tell anything about when you get a value which is mod x is less than 1. That means an plus 1 upon an, limit n tends to infinity. If the quantity comes out to be 1, we cannot say anything. So here the quantity is mod x. So of course your mod x, when your mod x is equal to 1, we cannot say anything. So this is a case which we need to deal with, which we separately deal, right? So if you put mod x, let's say you put mod x is equal to 1. So that means you are actually dealing with the two things. One is what? X can be 1 or x can be
minus 1.
Okay, so let's talk about when I put x is equal to 1 in this series. Okay, so let's say we talk about x is equal to 1. So our series will become n runs from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n, 1 raised to power n upon n, which is equal to n raised from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n upon n. Now, can you tell me, is it a convergent series or a divergent?
Divergent.
Anyone?
Convergent.
Why it is convergent?
Leibniz test.
This is not harmonic series. This is alternating series, right? So we're going to apply the alternating test over here. Okay. So when you take that un, un should be positive and decreasing and limit n tends to infinity, it will come out to be 0. Of course, that will be what?
Convergent.
Okay. How? By Leibniz. Okay. So that is something you need to solve it properly. Okay, you write those steps and say that, then you finally conclude that, okay, for x is equal to 1, it converges. Okay, so let's say, what about x is equal to minus 1? What happens? Okay, so yeah, it was minus 1. Okay, let me put it minus 1 over. Otherwise, it doesn't make any difference over here. Okay, so let's say x is equal to minus 1. So now the series will become what? Minus 1 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1 raised to power n upon n. Now this becomes n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n minus 1 raised to power n minus 1 raised to power minus 1 upon n. And what about this? This will become minus 1 raised to power 2 n. So what will happen?
1.
Right? One. Even will happen. So, and that will become what? Negative. Okay. So you are left with, let's say, take that negative outside, and that will become 1 upon n. Now, can you tell me, is it convergent or divergent?
Divergent.
Right? That minus is outside. Now this is an entirely positive series. Okay. So now it's a harmonic series, classical divergent series. So which is divergent. Right. So how you started. So therefore, series is convergent when your x lying between minus 1 and 1. Why? Because you said that mod x is less than 1. Additionally, you also proved that when your x is 1, even then series will converge. So I'll put one equality over here. Okay. In order to include that case as well. And series is divergent when your mod x is greater than 1, right? So that means but I've also proved that at x is equal to minus 1, it is also divergent. So I'll also include that case as well. So I'll put a closed interval into that in order to make sure that case has also been included, right? Is it fine now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's see. Let's see, we have this thing. N runs from 0 to infinity xn upon factorial n. And we are asked that, tell us whether it is convergent or divergent. Okay, so let's. Now, we don't have minus 1 over here. But we also do not know about the values of x. So every time we need to take the, we need to consider the case of absolute divergence, because we don't have any idea about x. X can be negative as well. If you take the value of x to be negative, then it will become a, it will become an alternative series.
Alternating series.
Yeah. So that's why every time when we are dealing with a power series, we generally tend to take the modulus. Right? Because if we are talking about the absolute convergence, we know that if we are able to make the absolute convergence, then the original series will also be convergent. Because absolute convergence is a strong thing, right? That's what we have proved in one of our theorem, that if a series is absolutely convergent, then it is convergent. Okay? So that one result we are applying over here. So let's say, talk about, consider absolute convergence. That means this thing. So we'll take modulus with us. And now by ratio test, what are you going to do? Limit n tends to infinity an plus 1 upon an, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity an plus 1. That means we'll replace n by n plus 1 into n factorial upon mod xn. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. So here again, we are left with mod x. And here you keep n plus 1 outside, n factorial into n factorial. That will also get cancelled. So limit n tends to infinity mod x upon n plus 1. So what about this one? This quantity will be what?
Sir, zero.
Zero.
So this is always zero over here. So no matter what value of x you choose, it will always come out to be zero. Why? Because if you take any values of x, you in denominator, you will have n plus one. You take limit n tends to infinity, that will always come out to be zero. Is it okay? So
yes, sir.
So now what are you going to conclude? What are you going to conclude?
It always converges.
It is
absolutely
always
convergent.
Yes, yes. So therefore, the series is absolutely convergent. Right? Absolutely convergent. For which values of x? For
every value of x.
All values of x. Okay. So now if you look at the series again, you'll come to know that if you expand the series, this is going to be like 1 plus x upon 1 factorial, x upon 2 factorial, x upon 3 factorial, and so on up to infinity. And this series is equal to what?
Sir, x square upon 2 factorial.
Sorry. X square and x cube. Okay. So, and this series is equal to what?
Sir,
e. Yes. E raised to power x. Okay. And have you know that this is true, this can be defined for every value of x.
Yes, sir.
Isliye, the power series also tells the same thing with a different way, that this sum is always going to be convergent. Okay? Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
So are you getting the stuff?
Yes, sir.
Let's say try a very different example. Okay? So it's an entirely different one. So this is actually the four parts of example three, of course, in the 9th edition. So I'll give you the page number of the book is 665, right? I'm writing it over here, 665. So there is one more part, that is part B, which I'm leaving it for you. You can also try it. It is also very simple. You can check that on for which values of x the series is convergent and divergent. Okay. So I'm doing the rest of the three parts. Okay. So let's start with the last one. Now, this is, we want to this. Okay. So now, again, we don't know about the x. So x can be negative. So we are bound to only take the case of absolute convergence rather than discussing the regular convergence. Okay, so consider mod x. See, you know that obviously I'm not taking the mode around the factorial n because n is positive integer, right? So no need to take the modulus around it. So now again, you take this thing, that means an plus 1 upon an limit n tends to infinity mod xn plus 1 into n plus 1 factorial upon mod xn into n factorial, right? Now this will become what? Limit n tends to infinity n plus 1 we will take outside, n factorial mod x, we are left with mod x, na? Because here it is n plus 1 and here it is n, so of course you are left with mod x. Is it fine?
Yes, right?
Yes sir.
And factorial n is over here. So now what about this quantity?
It's infinity.
Yeah, this is a kind of reciprocal scenario of this thing, na? So earlier we used to have everywhere convergence. Now we will have everywhere divergence.
Divergence.
No matter which value of x you choose, you will always get the infinite. So therefore, given series is what? Is divergent. And divergent. For which values of x?
For every value of x.
All values of x. All real values of x. Right? Is it okay? So that's how we check the convergence and divergence of the power series. Example is, you need to check about this thing. Now, can you tell me what is that?
Alternating series.
Yes. Alternating series, but which series?
Alternating GP.
GP.
Yeah. So just talk about that as GP. That's it. Okay. So now if it is GP, you know that your common ratio is what?
X minus 2 by 2.
2, but with a negative sign. Right? Fine. Are you with me on this?
Yes, sir.
When your GP will converge?
Will
converge if mod R is
less than 1.
So that means mod x minus 2 upon 2 less than 1. So that means x minus 2 upon 2 less than 1. So that means minus 1, x minus 2 by 2 will lie between minus 1 to 1. So you multiply by 2. So x minus 2 will lie between minus 2 to 2. So you add 2 to the inequality. So your x will lie between 2 and 4. So for here, we conclude that our series will converge if your x belongs to 0 to 4. Okay. So let's say talk about the.
So please show the previous page for a second.
Yes, please.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So anything you want to ask? Right? So can we do it? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So basically, if we are dealing with this series, we'll also do what? We'll generally apply. So I'm writing few steps that how we're going to deal with the power series. Okay. First thing, we generally apply the ratio test or root test. Mostly, right? Ratio or root test. And we'll get a thing which is generally like x minus a is less than r. X minus a is less than r. Or we generally say that a minus r to a plus r. That's what we find, right? generally, we, if we are talking about convergence, as we have done in the last example as well. Okay. So next thing is what? So this is, if your absolute convergence is finite, right? Then you need to check at the end point as well. Okay. So secondly, you know that if interval of absolute convergence is finite, then also check the convergence or divergence at end points. At end points, right? That is one way. And we generally do it by applying different condition. Let's say Leibniz test. Have we done this? Have you done this kind of example? Second point, samajh aa raha hai? See, you talk about the very first example. वहां पे हमने क्या किया, वी चेक द कन्वर्जेंस, राइट, एंड आर इंटरवल ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस वॉज फाइनाइट, इनफाइनाइट पे तो नहीं हुआ ना, सो देयरफॉर वी हैड टू चेक इट एट मॉड एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन, सो वी चेक्ड एट द एंड पॉइंट्स एज वेल, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कंक्लूडेड कि एट वन इट इज कन्वर्जेंट, एट माइनस वन इट इज डाइवर्जेंट, एंड वी चेक्ड यूजिंग द व्हाट, लेबनीज टेस्ट हियर. ओके, got my point?
Yes, sir. Sure.
But sometimes yes, it may happen, as we have done in a second example, it was so nice to us that it is convergent everywhere. That means if I'm talking about the convergence, interval of convergence in this thing, so that means it is true for every value. That means minus infinite to infinite. So we don't have any finitely many endpoints. So we don't need to check that whether it is convergent or divergent at endpoints. Right? Right? So in this case, we didn't check. Even that case was also a very bad case where the whole series was divergent everywhere. Even in that case also, we don't need to check whether it is convergent or divergent at endpoints. So we generally say what? So first of all, we generally have this kind of expression. Secondly, we check the absolute convergence. If your interval of convergence is finite, then we need to check at the endpoints as well. Otherwise, we don't need to check at the endpoint as well. Okay, so also I'll add last point, that is what, if series is absolutely convergent in, let's say, a minus r to a plus r, as we have done, then it is divergent for which values? For mod x minus a greater than r. Okay, so that is what we're gonna say. So outside it is greater, so it is divergent. So that's it. So what I'm saying is, so this R is called the radius of convergence. R is called the radius of convergence. And your this thing, that means X belongs to A minus R to A plus R, in this case, is called the interval of convergence. Fine? ओके, समझ आ रही है ये चीज, बोलो जरा.
यस सर.
पॉइंट्स एक्सप्लेन कर दो फिर से.
ठीक है, सो आई एम सेइंग दैट इन दैट केस योर आर इज रेडियस ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस एंड दिस इंटरवल वेयर द सीरीज इज कन्वर्जेंट वी कॉल इट एज अ इंटरवल ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस. नाउ आई रीइटरेट दोस एग्जांपल्स व्हिच वी हैव डन. सो नाउ इफ यू सी दैट, लेट्स से वेरी फर्स्ट एग्जांपल. So what about this example? What is the radius of convergence in this example? See, you don't need to check about the endpoints if you are talking about the radius of convergence. Okay. So this is your mod x is less than one. So if you talk about the center of the series was zero, so you write it as this way. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll explain at the last page. So in very first example, so you got x minus 0 is less than 1. So if you compare it with this, what is your radius of convergence?
1.
And what is center?
0.
0.
Yes. Okay. So if you talk about the next case, second example, that was Ex and it was convergent everywhere. So in that case, your mod x minus 0 was less than infinite. So then your R was infinite. Why? Because it is convergent everywhere. And your radius was zero. In third case, it was convergent nowhere. So your A was zero and your R was also zero because it was divergent everywhere. Right? Okay. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
That's it for today. You want to